Hi, my name is Son Olsen, and welcome to this video where we will talk about inverse kinematics. The usual way of animating is called forward kinematics, or FK. Forward kinematics is a top-down approach. For example, on an arm, to position the hand, the upper arm is rotated and then the lower arm. All animation can be achieved this way, but some types are very difficult. For example, if we want to keep the hand in place as the rest of the body moves, we'll have to adjust the arm bones continuously, which requires many keys. A better solution for this is inverse kinematics, or IK. IK is a bottom-up approach. Here, we set the hand position, and then spine automatically sets the rotation for the upper and lower arm bones. IK can be used for many other tasks, such as keeping feet from penetrating the floor during a walk animation or adjusting the IK target at runtime to stand on uneven terrain. In spine, bones can be controlled by either FK, IK, or a mix of both. It is also possible to transition smoothly between FK and IK during an animation. IK is used with three bones: the parent, the child, and the target bone. Optionally, IK can be used with only two bones to have the bones always look at the target. With a three bone setup, the child bone must be a direct descendant of the parent bone. To begin using IK, first select the parent and child bones. Then click New and then IK Constraint. Now, either click in a blank space to create the target bone or select an existing bone. If choosing an existing bone as the target, this bone cannot be a descendant of the parent bone. The IK constraint continually adjusts the rotation of the parent and child bones, so now when I move the target, the tip of the child bone is at the target bone. The direction the parent and child bones bend can be changed by selecting the constraint in the tree and then toggling the bend direction. Note that the bones now be hollow in the viewport to indicate that the bone is being controlled by constraint. The mix slider on the IK constraint controls how much the bone is affected by the constraint. When mix is 0, only FK is used, and when set to 100, only IK is used. A mix between 0 and 100 results in both FK and IK affecting the bone at the same time. Lines are drawn to show where the bones are in FK and IK poses. When the constraint is disabled, the bones are shown at the FK pose and can be transformed as normal. Note that attachment for constraint bones cannot be edited while the constraint is disabled. Clicking the key icon sets a key for the bend direction and mix, which are always keyed together. Keying the mix is often useful to enable and disable IK during animations. The graph can be used to apply a curve to IK keys, so the speed of the mix transition can be customized. So, I hope you found this video helpful, and I hope to see you again for the next one. Bye for now.